but I always painted and I drew pictures. And I wrote poetry. As I grew up, I became an art therapist. And I began to combine words and images with the idea of helping people through the way in which art can communicate. When I was pregnant with my daughter, Hannah, 30 years ago, I began writing poetry that shared what was in my heart, the dreams, the wishes, the hopes that I had for this unborn child. That poetry later became the book Welcome, Little One. I hope that my work inspires moms and dads and grandparents and teachers and caregivers, that we are the leaders, we are the messengers that tell each and every child that they are special, that they are unique, that they belong, and ultimately that they are loved. In my books, I address all sorts of issues and ideas that require conversations in families with parents and children. Things like what makes us different, and that being different is what matters, because we matter because we are different, and embracing all sorts of uniqueness and creativity and ideas that make each one of us so special. I talk about having big ideas and dreams and reaching for the stars, encouraging and inspiring the next generation. You know, I talk about how important it is to care for each other, to be kind, and to reach out to people who need help. You know, my books are all about love, and I think as parents share that with their children, they will internalize and bring those messages into the world, and it'll help them grow to be all they're meant to be. I remember recently going to a book signing and to a book reading, and this little girl, I heard her say to her mom, "There's Miss Sandra." And she grabbed hold of my leg and looked at me and couldn't speak. It was so, so cute. Her mom said, "She just loves your books." I sort of felt like Big Bird that night. It was great. You know, all of my fans are little ones. I call them my little peeps. And I love reading with them. I love seeing their pictures when they send them during emails or on social media. I love hearing what they think about the ideas and the stories and the characters. You know, I write them for them. I love hearing from the kids and their parents, and it's my favorite time to get a message from any of the parents or teachers or kids who read my books. I'm very, very grateful. Three books come to mind that were really meaningful to us. They were the books that I read as a child. The first one was Winnie the Pooh. I read her all of the Winnie the Pooh stories because Winnie shared everything about compassion and kindness and being a really good friend. I read Nancy Drew books to her as she got older because Nancy was like this independent, free-spirited, idealistic, you know, really forward-thinking girl, and I really wanted my daughter to hear those stories. And then there was a book I read called The Present for the Princess, and it was about a little blind boy who grew strawberries for the visit of a princess. And he really asked all of nature what to create and what's the best gift of all, and it really was a gift from his heart. So those books and those stories really formed the foundation of the ideas I wanted to share with my daughter and to kids everywhere. I believe books touch lives. They can change lives. Every single word, every single image, the story within those pages speaks to the reader's heart. So to me, being able to personalize a book with a child's name, their photograph, put them inside the pages of the book is life-altering. It's incredible. It's fantastic. And I think a child who has read a book where they are the lead character, where they are the hero, where they see themselves creating that story, is something that will help them grow to be all they are meant to be.